the government of the day banned the wearing of the kilt. It was an English government. Hello! Just talking about you. Most of them from near London. And they banned the wearing of the kilt because they said that the tartan was a badge of national identity. So we had to wear trousers. But we still had all the tartan, which we made into the pants and the trousers. So for years and years and years, all the men in Scotland looked like professional golfers. It's true. The dance in Scotland is seen through such the tartan trousers, and it's danced in the traditional fashion. The great Highland bagpipe. There he is, Pipe Major Tom Wilson. Tom, go for it. And Chris Cusp Finlay will give us the chanteries.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, behold the star of the show. Behold the haggis. Now, for those of you who have never seen a haggis before in all its glory, let me clear up any doubts you may be having at this point, in case you're wondering. These here, for example, these are not attached to the haggis. Nor will they ever attach to a Harley Davidson or a BMW. These are purely for decoration. It is, of course, it's this part here that is the haggis. Prepared, as you can all see, in the traditional fashion, by our young master chef, young Manuel. His bill of fare. Oh, Scotland one, man, stinking where the jobs and luggage. But if you want a grateful prayer, gie her a haggis. Yes, raise your glasses, folks. The toast is from one and all, quite simply, to the haggis. To the haggis! We'll be right back. worrying about that. Let's thank all those who've entertained us this evening. And Pike Major, there he is. We're almost finished, but how we're going to finish is how we always finish, Jamie's, and that is with our grateful thanks to you all. We've been a great bunch, and with us all singing together this Robbie Williams song, Should Sure.